The Backup and Migrate module allows you to backup and restore your Drupal site from within the Drupal user interface. Here I have a simple Drupal site with two pieces of content, a test article and an image, and an about page. If you go to the content overview page, you will see those two nodes. To use the Backup and Migrate module, first you need to enable it in the modules section. Enable Backup and Migrate and the Backup and Migrate Files modules. Once those modules are enabled, go to Configuration, System, Backup and Migrate to access the Backup and Migrate options. On Stanford sites, there is a custom profile set up to make backups quick and easy. On the Quick Backup page, it is set to backup the default database to the manual backups directory using the Stanford sites profile. Click Backup Now to create a backup of the database, and a database backup file with a timestamp is created on the server. Choose Public Files Directory from the Backup From drop-down menu to create a backup of your files directory, then click Backup Now. A backup archive of your files directory with a timestamp is created on the server. Drupal stores files separate from the database, so it's necessary to create separate backups of the database and the files directory. Examples of information stored in the database include module settings, user profiles, content information, and so forth. Examples of what is stored in the files directory include images, PDFs, Word documents, and so forth. Most users will only use the public files directory, so that's usually all you need to back up. If you're using private files, you'll likely know that, and you should back that directory up as well, if so. You can review the files in the manual backups directory by clicking Destinations, then List Files. You'll see the two backups that you just created. Now that we have a backup, let's delete content. I'm going to delete the article and page that I had created. You can see that they're gone from the menu and the front page. Let's restore from our backup. Go to the Destinations tab in the Backup and Migrate settings and click the Restore link next to your database backup file. Note the warning. This is potentially a dangerous process and you should not perform this on a live production site. See the additional documentation on creating a development site for more information. Click the Restore button. In a bit of technical wizardry, the Backup and Migrate module is deleting the Drupal database and restoring it from your backup file. This can take up to several minutes depending on the size of your database. Now let's repeat the process with the backup of the public files directory. Note in the advanced options that you have the option to take the site offline while performing a restore. After restoring the database and files directory, I go back to the home page, and there are my article and about page.